Thank you for coming to the 2018 Fort Stockton ISC Spring Band Concert and Senior Recognition. Before we begin, just a few words about concert etiquette so all in attendance can enjoy this evening's performances.
Refrain from talking. This is the number one rule. Whispering during the music, disciplining, or entertaining your children is very distracting and rude to the performers.
Please silence your phones and refrain from texting, Snapchatting, or Facebooking. There are infinite other places those activities can take place.
If you need to leave the auditorium during the concert, please wait until the band is not playing. This applies to entering as well. The exception is if you have an unruly child. If that might occur during the concert, positioning yourself near an exit is recommended.
Please, if you are videoing, remain seated. Everyone would like a clear view of the performance.
Please remain until the conclusion of the concert. All of tonight's musicians have worked very hard to prepare an enjoyable program and would like to perform to a full auditorium.
If we can all extend these simple courtesies this evening, it will allow a better experience for all involved, performers and audience alike.
Thank you for your attention. And now, please welcome the Middle School Beginning Band under the direction of Mr. Brant Sager.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Hopefully, if one of these kiddos up here is yours, hopefully this sounds a lot better than it did about, when did we start, about 10 months? No, not 10 months, maybe 8, 9 months ago. Hopefully the sounds that you first heard, and you're probably thinking, oh my goodness. Hopefully this is a lot better, because these kids have been working really hard. That song was called Tempest. That's actually one of my all-time favorite songs. That was actually written when I was in middle school. I'm not gonna tell you how long ago that was. I'm a lot older than you probably think. But I first heard that when I was in 8th grade, and our 6th grade band played it, and I've loved it ever since. And so I thought these guys would love it too, and it's loud and fast, and it's a lot of fun. But the last song we're gonna play for you is a song that everybody knows. If you feel like dancing along, and you're not ashamed, hey, go for it. Go for it. All right, and this is called La Cucaracha. Second, we're going to try to transition and get the next group on, try to get this going pretty fast. We've got lots of music here tonight. Somebody turn the house lights on. Just want to make sure nobody falls. I'm not sure who's. Hey, thank you. Thank you. All right, we'll get on with the rest of our program. Thank you so much for being patient. Up next, we've got our concert band, and under the direction of Mrs. Lindsay Kilgore. And the first song they're going to be playing is a circus march called Front and Center. On. Thank you for being patient again. This is our symphonic band at the middle school. The first song we're going to be playing is actually the first march I ever learned to play when I was in the seventh grade. It's called Newcastle March. Drum second to get set up. The next song we're gonna play is this is probably like if you got kids like me, just like whenever Frozen came out, everybody needed music. And in my house, Moana is the same way. We watch that movie probably almost, I don't know, twice, three times a week. And so, but one thing I love to do, even though we're playing Moana, it sounds easy, but some of the kids don't realize really how tricky that music is. But with a spring concert, I love to just go for it and play really, really, really difficult stuff, because this is actually a version of Moana that our high school band could play. And it gave us some challenges at first, but these guys are getting really good, and so I hope you enjoy it. It will feature Mr. Everin Gonzalez on alto saxophone. Thank you.
right, so this year we started our middle school color guard, our winter guard. And at our championships, one of our, I guess, members actually came out as the outstanding all-star color guard, and that would be Ariana Sloan.
Okay. Congratulations. Before we play our last piece, I just wanted to say thank you all again for coming out and supporting these kiddos. This has been a tremendous year, as you can tell. We're kind of bragging on these kids a lot with that table over there, all those trophies. The big ones over there, we actually went on a van trip. A lot of you know this. Oh my gosh, thank you. We went up to Lubbock to the Irons Middle School Music Festival, and we actually not only came back with sweepstakes, or I guess for them it's a superior rating, it's the same thing as sweepstakes trophies, their version of it, and we also got the best in our classification with all the middle schools that compete with us. Even though there were other middle schools, they're the kind of the bigger schools, but in our classification, we actually came out number one in not just the symphonic band, but also the concert band. So I thought that was really cool. These guys, that was really awesome. The last song that we're gonna play is a piece that I first heard when I was in third grade, I believe. 1991. Yes, I was in third grade. You can do the math. My brother was actually in high school at the time. I think he was a freshman or sophomore. And this piece had just come out. It was brand new. Everybody was talking about it. And when I heard it in third grade, I was like, man, I want to do that. It was just awesome. And then finally in eighth grade, my band director decided to play it, and we all went crazy because we all remembered it when we were younger. And so I'm getting to have some fun with these guys and show them one of the pieces that really, probably for middle school, bought me into bands. It's just really cool. You're gonna hear the band doing some neat things. You probably see the glasses that the kids up here have. You're gonna see kids doing some weird stuff. You might even see the percussion doing some interesting things in the back, but it's a lot of fun. So this whole piece should sound pretty much like you're in Jurassic Park and the dinosaurs are battling. It's a lot of fun. So thank you again for coming out, and I really hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
I So I don't get off and ramble, which I'm probably going to do anyway. But I want to show extreme gratitude to our technology department. We've had so much, we got so many kids in the band and so many adults that come to watch and family members that the Christmas concert was a little bit overcrowded. And so they're live streaming this into our gym, which is where the band students are. And so they're over there, and so you can enjoy it, and it's more fun for everybody. So thank you to Mr. Villanueva, Rudy Basubia, and Tristan Barragon for making that happen for us. I showed up tonight and I didn't know if it was going to work. So I want to start. We have a lot of awards to give tonight. It's a spring concert celebration recognition. But I need to read something to you. A lot of you are aware this is going on, but maybe not all of you, and there's been some recent developments. Several weeks ago, I received an email from Congressman Will Hurd letting me know that we have been nominated to represent Texas in the National Veterans Day Parade. That's wrong. It's the National Memorial Day Parade. I responded that we humbly accept the nomination. And then later, I received this. Dear Mr. Darrington, based on the official nomination from Congressman Will Hurd, the American Veterans Center and Music Celebrations International are pleased to invite the Fort Stockton Pride of Panterland Marching Band to participate and perform in the National Memorial Day Parade in Washington, D.C. on May 27, 2019 as an official representative of the state of Texas. And I have this. And then last night, at the request of Superintendent Traynor, the school board voted unanimously to not only approve the trip, but to fund it. So, thank you so much to everyone involved in that decision making. We're going to Washington, D.C. next year. All right. Now we'll continue the music. Thank you. All right, I have a few awards that we're gonna give out at this time. First, if you received a first division on a solo or an ensemble, which was ways back, that was back in early February, or if you were placed into the all-region band, would you stand up in time and please be recognized? If you advanced to the state solo and ensemble contest, would you please stand and be recognized? Okay, thank you. If you advanced to the area round of ATSSB's All-State process, would you please stand and be recognized? And we do actually have one All-State band member in our midst, but we'll get to that later. At this time, if Ms. Kilgore is handy, all right. There she is. We need to give out a certificate that was earned earlier this season, and I'll let her have the mic.
So, for high school, we also were given a All-Star Color Guard member during our championship round at our Cap Rock Color Guard circuit, and that person was Bailey Terman.
Now, it's kind of hard to see earlier whenever we were talking about the All-State solo and ensemble participants. That contest hasn't happened yet. It's next Monday for us. Our percussion section, I think it's either 7 or 8 members qualified. They're going to perform. It's not on the program, by the way. They're going to perform for you the ensemble that they are playing next week. They're still moving equipment, so I'm a little concerned. Are they ready, Ms. Jewell? Almost. While we're waiting for them, let me give out one more award. We have our outstanding freshman, sophomore, and junior band awards. They're not all about the seniors, although I am about seniors. You gotta be a freshman before you can become a senior. So there's these beautiful little plaques that we had made for them, and it says outstanding, this particular one says freshman, member award presented to the name. Thank you for your effort, integrity, loyalty, and leadership. Fort Stockton Pride of Pantherland Band 2017-2018. Our outstanding freshman is Audrey Gonzalez. We just heard our outstanding sophomore play a beautiful solo, Leanna Uresti. And our outstanding junior is Kiara Alvarez. Congratulations, ladies. All right. I'm going to go ahead and give one more since they're listed together. We have a lot of student athletes, but we here in Fort Stockton, we also have musician athletes. And so we have our very special Outstanding Musician Athlete Award. This lady is not just a fantastic athlete, but she's spirited and she is a fantastic cheerleader. Congratulations, Annika. Solo coming up here a little bit in one of our last pieces. All right, we're going to continue. It looks like our percussion section is ready to go under the direction of Ms. Sarah Jewell. Last year at this time, Ms. Jewell was in the audience. She drove here from a town in Arkansas. I can't remember which one. She was sitting right over there with my wife because I was trying to get her to come work here. And she liked what she heard and she liked the kids she met, and she came here and she is just. She's really enhanced what we're doing, and man, you're going to get to hear what she's been able to do with these kids. So, Ms. Jewell, it's all yours. No?
Thank you.
Ms. Jewell actually had an entire concert Friday that was just percussion, but for the sake of time, we only had the high school ensemble play tonight. Plus, those of you that went, she didn't say anything. There were two players short, and they still sounded that good Friday night. But that's going to be an ongoing thing that we'll do every year, so keep your eyes out for that. It's just all percussion ensembles and some fun stuff, and you know, the neat thing about drums is if you can hit it, it's a drum. Okay, moving on. I got a couple more awards here. The Texas Music Scholar. The Texas Music Scholar Award designates students in high school music programs who exemplify attributes of really awesome performance in the areas of scholarship, musicianship, and citizenship. Last year, fewer than 2,000 students in the state of Texas were named as Texas Music Scholars. They will receive this certificate from the Texas Music Educators Association and these really neat patches for their letter jackets. Our award winners this year are Michaela Alvarez, Austin Federer, Audrey Gonzalez, Isaiah Gonzalez, Cade Calca, Brianna Uresti, a little earlier, the ATSSB All-State Band. Earning a position in the All-State Band is the highest performance achievement for a Texas high school student. This year, Daniela Alvarez attained that distinction and spent 4 days in San Antonio rehearsing and performing with the ATSSB All-State Band at the Texas Music Educators Convention. At this time, I'd like to present her with the certificate from ATSSB as a keepsake. That is many, many, many hours of practice because that is a competitive thing and there's very few that get to do it. We're going to continue our performance now with Home. This is a piece that was selected by our seniors. It's our senior music. So let's continue. Thank you. All right, I have a few more awards, but before we do that, seniors, they do leave their legacy, and sometimes it's time to pass the torch. And so at this time, our drum majors are going to come up and present our next year's drum majors with the special plume and special gloves, and our color guard captain is going to present our next color guard captain with her special flag. Woo! We need Kiara and Jenny to come up here. Good job. For anybody that doesn't know, Kiara Alvarez and Jenny Reese are next year's drum majors. They auditioned and did it. And our color guard captain, Clarissa Barone, is giving Bailey Terman her special flag. Yeah! Twirl, spin, toss. Gotcha. She never drops, it'd be fine. Okay, I'm gonna let Miss Kilgore, I'll read, but I'll let her do it. One of the awards, we didn't give it last year because the award didn't come in time, but we selected someone last year, but they didn't know. They may not know now. But there's a National Color Guard Award. Now, all the following awards have running plaques that do hang in the band hall. Permanently. They're down now because we just got a new band hall, and I don't think we even own it yet. So we haven't hung them up, but we do have them, and they go back, some of them from all the way into the forever. And some of them are a little more recent that we started a few years ago. This is the National School Color Guard Award. For those of you that don't know Color Guard, they spin the flags on the field, and then they also do Winter Guard. This award honors the outstanding contributions of members of the Color Guard. Recipients of this award are recognized for their musical, visual, and dedication as student leaders whose example inspires others. And last year's recipient is...
Clarissa.
And this year's recipient is...
Olga Tavares.
So they have these plaques that are engraved with your names, and then there's one that will hang in the band hall forever. The next one is the National School Marching Award. It recognizes outstanding contributions on the field. It honors the musical contributions and dedication of student leaders whose example inspires others. And I told the kids the other day, I said, you're in fine company if you get your name on this plaque. Sydney Urias, Lizette Hernandez, and this year's recipient, Vanessa Lopez. Pick them up and have to take the picture with the running plaque later. If you'd like to do that, just please put it back. The Patrick Gilmore Award was introduced in 1994 in honor of legendary bandmaster Patrick Gilmer. And his band joined the Burnside's expedition to North Carolina in the Civil War. Gilmer also played for every president of his day, including Abraham Lincoln. This beautiful award honors outstanding high school band students and their achievements and commitment to the band. Past recipients have been Caitlin Paredes, Jacob Rodriguez, Natalie Vargas, and this year, Courtney Davis. And finally, the John Philip Sousa Award. Since its inauguration in 1954, thousands of U.S. high schools have presented the John Philip Sousa Band Award to their most outstanding band student. It is fitting that the award should be inspired by the name of John Philip Sousa, the premier American bandsman who was elected in 1973 to the Hall of Fame for Great Americans. No other composer is so well known to band students. In fact, we played a Sousa March for Contest, where they got straight ones, by the way. Sousa was one of the most renowned supporters of school music programs. The award recognizes those young musicians displaying superior musicianship, leadership, dependability, loyalty, cooperation, and other qualities of conduct which school instrumental music programs strive to impart. The Sousa Award is the top nationwide prize in the school band field, both in prestige and appearance. It promotes the entire band by encouraging musicians to achieve to greater achievement with enthusiasm while providing an inspiring stimulus for potential instrumentalists. My goodness, there's a lot of big words there. This year's there's too many past recipients to name them all. However, in the past 2 years, Rachel Pruitt and David Graves have received this award. And this year's This year's recipient of the John Philip Sousa Award is Isaiah Gonzalez. This for his desk, and I was afraid I'd lose it, so I put it in my pocket. And you get a lapel pin to wear at every performance, so everyone will know that you are in an elite club. I know that's a lot of awards, but these kids have worked hard and they've stuck with it for years, and so it's nice to take a moment to acknowledge their contributions and their achievements. And now music from The Incredibles. Oh, I'm so glad there's gonna be a new one come out in a couple of weeks. Hello, and let's go. All right. All right. Seniors, your moment has arrived. We could get you all to come down here in front of the stage. Now, I'm going to be honest. We're going to try something after we hear the gun. And then I actually didn't know what we're going to do. Go get you. Hey, seniors, you're going to get down in front of the stage. Down there. That's not that bad. Yeah, there they go. You're going to walk the stage twice. Tonight, you're going to walk. Don Williams, I don't know. I've been telling these kids for a couple of weeks, enjoy it. Enjoy graduating high school. I'm supposed to have a mommy handy to read the names. Here we go. So now we pause to recognize the 2018 senior class of the Pride of Bantherland Band. These outstanding young men and women began their careers as so many others, but their perseverance and dedication will leave a lasting legacy on this band and Fort Stockton High School. Countless miles traveled on buses to football games, contests, festivals, endless quick meals of pizza and chicken strips, disappointments and victories all helped to shape the outstanding individuals they now are. They're Panthers, they're Prowlers, and they are leaders ready to begin their journey past high school and make a lasting impression on people they have yet to meet. As they are called to walk across the stage tonight, they will receive gifts from the Booster Club and graduation cards representing 4 years of band service. Congratulations to you all, senior class of 2018.
Daniela Almarez. Daniela plans to attend Angelo State University and major in kinesiology to achieve state and eventually national certification as an athletic trainer. She also plans to be a member of the Ram Band. Clarissa Barron. Clarissa plans to move to California and major in business and dance.
Yeah. Go, Clarissa!
Yeah. Harley Crenshaw. Harley plans to move to Bryan, Texas with her sister Brittany to attend Blinn College before pursuing a degree in marine biology at Corpus Christi A&M. Courtney plans to attend Angelo State University and minor in psychology while majoring in criminal justice. She then will follow a career as a forensic scientist or work for the FBI. Annika Danda. Annika will attend the University of Texas at San Antonio and major in psychology. She will then transfer to the University of Texas at Austin to receive her MD and become a child psychiatrist. She hopes to return to Fort Stockton or San Antonio and work at a hospital and later opened her own practice. Ellie Favela. Upon graduation, Ellie will attend Minden College to become a traveling nurse. Isaiah Gonzalez. Isaiah plans to attend the University of Texas Permian Basin to earn a degree in music education and begin a career as a band director. Stacy Jamison. Stacy plans to attend Sol Ross State University to study pre-veterinary medicine and be a 4-H manager. She will then transfer to Texas A&M to earn a master's degree in veterinary medicine for large and small animals. She then hopes to return to Fort Stockton and open a clinic and be a traveling veterinarian. Vanessa Lopez. To major in psychology. After earning her PhD and becoming a licensed psychologist, Vanessa will return to Fort Stockton. Andrea Macias. Andrea's plans include attending Angelo State University to earn a degree in border and homeland security while pursuing a minor in psychology with hopes of becoming a Texas State Trooper. Melanie Magallanes. After graduation, Melanie plans to attend Odessa College to earn a license in cosmetology and a degree in business. She will then return to school and study forensic science and major in forensic psychology. Daisy Montoya. Daisy is planning to continue her work at the hospital and attend Midland College in the fall to obtain her LVN. Gabriel Natera. He plans to attend the University of Texas Permian Basin for 2 years and then transfer to Texas Tech University to receive a Bachelor of Arts degree in history. He also hopes to go on to become a state trooper. Christopher Ramirez. Attend Midland College for 2 years before transferring to the University of Texas Permian Basin and earn a bachelor's degree in kinesiology. Perla Roberts. Perla will get her basics at WRTC and will later attend the Pratt Institute in Brooklyn, New York to study art. Perla wants to become a tattoo artist and paint the planet a whole new color, one person at a time. Yeah. Tristan Reyes. Yeah. After graduation, Tristan will attend Odessa College with plans of pursuing a career in culinary arts. Rebecca Rodriguez. Rebecca plans to attend Midland College in the spring and then transfer to Texas Tech University or the University of Texas at Austin to pursue a career in pharmaceuticals. Celeste Salazar. Celeste will attend the
majoring in social work with a minor in childhood education. After receiving her bachelor's degree, Celeste will either continue her education or begin her journey helping others. Olga Tavares. Olga will attend the Art Institute at Austin to receive her Bachelor of Fine Arts in Fashion Design and one day work for Mattel as a designer for Barbie. In the meantime, she will continue to work on art and become a famous artist.
All right, so we've had such a great concert. Let's risk it all on one last spin of the wheel. All right, middle school, hurry, get in here. We're gonna honor the seniors with every band student in Fort Stockton playing the school song, oh, and Surprise High School and the fight song. Every one of them, hurry. Hurry, I gotta get their rest. They are so slow. Also, I was asked if senior parents could stick around for just a sec. At the end, that'd be awesome. Everyone else, we'll be back over tomorrow night. I got some remind things for new, upcoming freshman band members. Or maybe you just missed out. That's my reminder. That's how I get information out. And we're hurrying on the stage. Risk it all. Thank you so much for coming out tonight and supporting your kids. If we didn't do it, nobody would.